Welcome to LearnSaxophoneOnline.com. I'm Jeff Cunningham, and in this video, I'm going to talk about the embouchure. The steps I share with you will help you develop a proper embouchure, but because your mouths are a little bit different, you may need to make some slight adjustments and experiment a little. If you have an issue producing a tone, don't worry, just keep on practicing on a daily basis, and many of these issues resolve themselves. So let's begin with the steps. First of all, we'll just use our mouthpiece, ligature and reed attached to the neck. The top teeth rest on top of the mouthpiece. The top lip rests on top of the mouthpiece. Don't tuck the top lip over the top teeth. The bottom lip needs to go over the bottom teeth. The question is how much? The answer, the whole lip. More specifically, the lip and the skin, where it comes together, we'll call the lip line. Place this line directly over the top of the bottom teeth. Feel free to make slight adjustments to improve the tone. For example, with my embouchure, my lip line goes a little bit past the top of my bottom teeth. Next, the bottom teeth should be a little bit in front of the top teeth. If you blow air on the tip of your nose, you'll notice that your jaw will move forward slightly. The forward placement of the jaw is the general feeling that we want. Now, how to seal the mouth or embouchure around the mouthpiece and reed. We have a natural tendency to put pressure on top of the mouthpiece and on the bottom where the reed is, kind of like a coin purse. If you close it, there will be pressure on the top and the bottom only. Instead, think of a drawstring bag. You pull it closed and it closes in a circular fashion. We want a circular seal around the mouthpiece. The top lip and the bottom lip naturally put pressure on the mouthpiece and reed. However, the corners do not. In order to apply the drawstring analogy to our embouchure, we take the corners and we bring them in. If you need more of a description, let's follow this three-step process. First, open your mouth like this. Second, make a small, tight circle with your lips, not moving your jaw and leaving an opening in the center. Third, take your lip and put it over your bottom teeth, as we've discussed. Insert the mouthpiece and close your jaw, putting pressure on the reed with your jaw. Also, remember that the top teeth rest on top of the mouthpiece, and we don't tuck the top lip over the top teeth. All embouchure muscles are now pushing in towards the center from every angle. Now we discuss how much mouthpiece goes into your mouth. If you hold up the mouthpiece sideways and close one eye, you'll be able to see where the mouthpiece and the reed come together, forming a V. At the bottom of the V, take your pencil and draw a line across the reed. Place your thumb on the line and bring the mouthpiece up to your mouth using your thumb as a measurement for how much mouthpiece goes into your mouth. Remove the thumb from the reed and you have your placement. Now we finally get to play the saxophone, or at least the mouthpiece and the neck. But there's one more item that we must cover so you can get the best tone possible. That is, how much pressure do you put on the reed with your jaw? And the best way I can share this with you is to play you examples. The first example is the goal that we're going for, a good solid tone. The next example is putting too much pressure on the reed. The next example is not putting enough pressure on the reed. Once again, here's your good example and the goal that you're going for. In order to accomplish this, have this tone in your ear or in your mind and experiment with the amount of pressure you use with your jaw on the reed. I understand that there's a lot of information and detail here. Just take it step by step, take it one day at a time, and as you do this, you will get better and better every day. Don't try to solve all your issues in one day. After even a week, you'll notice that your tone improves and you'll feel more comfortable with it. So have fun, experiment a lot, and we'll see you soon.